Hill right now. Opening statements are underway in the House Armed Services Committee hearing that's being held on the administration's strategy against the Islamic terrorists of ISIS. Republican Chairman Buck McEwen is expressing concern this morning about the limitations President Obama has put on our military.
The OCO budget amendment that we received Monday afternoon pays for the air campaign and adds more advisors, but it does not appear to reflect any changes in strategy. However, we know that targeting and airstrikes are getting harder as ISIL changes tactics, and limiting our advisors to headquarters buildings will not help newly trained Iraqi and Syrian opposition, their forces, to hold terrain, much less defeat ISIL in the field. Yet the president has doubled down on his policy of no boots on the ground, despite any advice you have given him.
So will our strategy change? And if so, what will it be? Gillian Turner was a member of the White House National Security Council under President Bush and President Obama. Welcome this morning. First of all, we just heard from Buck McEwen, kind of raising concern and issues that this ISIS cannot be defeated without American boots on the ground. Do you think the administration will eventually turn that way?
I think the reports about a new White House strategy for Syria are really overstating what's happening inside the White House right now. I've spoken to senior administration officials this week who maintain that, yes, they want to defeat ISIS. Yes, Assad eventually has to go. But it's not in our national security interest to pursue both of these objectives at once. I think what is happening inside the White House is the president's team is constantly recalibrating based on unfolding events on the ground, but that there's this idea that, you know, we want to take on one first and then the other is not necessarily, you know, set in stone, and we want to avoid taking on both simultaneously as well.
Well, what does that recalibration you speak of mean? I mean, is it possible that we could potentially impose a no-fly zone over Syria, that we could bomb Assad's runways and stop his barrel bombing of the innocent citizens that he's been killing? Could they take on Assad at the same time we try to take on ISIS?
Well, look, Syria is the linchpin in the fight against ISIS, and it has been since day one. The U.S. wants to prevent Syria from becoming a safe haven for ISIS fighters as they get driven out of Iraq, and wants to ensure that whatever actions we take don't inadvertently bolster the Syrian regime. The rub, as you mentioned, comes with our allies in the region, like Turkey, like the Kurds, who really think that Assad poses a much graver and much more imminent threat than ISIS, and wants the president to focus on ousting him first. As far as we are able to tell now, though, the administration is holding firm to the position that they don't want to take on both simultaneously.
Well, why not? Why don't they? Why don't they want to take on Assad? I mean, it seems pretty easy to bomb his airfields and try to have that no-fly zone. It would be, you would think, within the capability of the American military to do that, to at least try to hold him back.
The fear is that by trying to oust Assad at the same time or before focusing on ISIS in Iraq, there would be somewhat of a sort of crisis of leadership, a vacuum created by Assad being taken out of the picture. And what that would do in terms of further destabilizing the country in the midst of this poses a really scary threat. So, I think that's what they're worried about more than the capability to sort of militarily handle both at once.
And meanwhile, they talk about training the Syrian rebels, 5,000, you know, a year. It's going to be at least a year or so before they are ready. So, Gillian, what do you think is going to happen? How does this play out? And can we defeat ISIS?
Well, look, it's 96 days into airstrikes in Iraq, 50 days that we've been doing airstrikes in Syria, and this is costing the U.S. government $8 million a day, plus the original $5.5 billion that President Obama recently requested for training and equipping, as you mentioned. So, you know, that's why we're seeing this House Armed Services Committee hearing today. Congress wants accountability for how and why this money is being spent from people like Chairman Dempsey and Secretary Hagel, who really have a say.
Well, they're doing that right now as ISIS continues. See how it goes. Gillian, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you for having me.
Right. Martha?
Well, the push to roll back.